Okay, y'all, so let's get into my project pan slash monthly makeup basket for the month of August. I've made some really good progress. I've finished up two items, which I did happen to spoil in last week's empties video, if y'all saw that. But nevertheless, I am actually still proud of the progress that I made because next month I have a feeling that a lot of these things are gonna be used up. And I need something positive today. I'm not having the best day. I'm just like kind of frustrated, you know, and kind of have a short fuse a little bit. Clutter has been really getting to me today. Not my clutter, I might add, but it's just kind of made the task that I need to do today a little bit more difficult. Hence, the reason why I'm trying to use all this stuff up so I'm not faced with more clutter when I need to pack it and move. Just one of those days where I really want to be in Maui already, and it's like, oh, I have 3 months left to go, like nearly to the day, and it just feels defeating. I'm trying to be grateful, I truly am trying to cultivate gratitude, but you know, we all have bad days. Anyway, so let's get into it. Like I said, I finished up two products, my perfume of the month and then one other item. So let's talk perfume of the month for the last month. It is the Givenchy Very Irresistible La Intense, or perhaps I should say it was in the past tense because I did finish it up. Hopefully you can see there, I had about a quarter of the bottle left and I was able to knock it out as per usual. I'm pretty good at using up perfume. It's definitely what I would personally classify as a winter scent. That's typically the only time that I used it, but I kind of had to get over that, and I still do. I need to use stuff up, so winter, spring, summer, whatever, I just need to use it, and that was kind of my philosophy with this. Although I did quite enjoy it, even though it was a little bit heavier and still quite warm outside, I did still enjoy it, but definitely glad it's gone. And then the only other product that I used up was my mini size of the Stellar Brilliant Primer. And if you can see, I really didn't have a whole lot left, especially for a mini size, but it did actually last me quite well. I received this little mini as like a point perk or a coupon code or something, and I fell in love with it and bought the full size. And now that full size, that's why I wanted to use this up. The full size is the only primer I own now, and I love it. It's so good. One of my favorite primers I have ever encountered. Anyway, so only a mini, but one more item out of my makeup collection, I cannot complain. So let's go ahead and move on to the products that I have made progress on, and I have made some good progress on the vast majority of these. First one up is the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. This is a full size in the old packaging. And might I add, I am kind of glad they switched it to anything but white, to be honest with you, because it gets really like foundation fingerprints all over it. It gets kind of grody. Anyway though, I won't have to worry about that for long because it is almost done for. And by the way, these lines are really approximations. It's very, very difficult to kind of get a perfect line on this bottle. You can't see through it, so you kind of have to peer into it and take a guess based on like the letters that you're seeing from the back ass side of it. Anyways, so that is approximately where I was when I started, so about a third of the product left. I am down to approximately right here now. So I would like to say I'm going to use this up in the next month. If I wear makeup very consistently, I very well likely do so, but who knows? Worst case scenario, next couple of months and it'll be gone. So let's move on to the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer in the shade Light. I have been on a journey with this product, I will tell you what. I did pop the stopper out of it. I was starting to get less and less. Probably could have waited a little bit longer, but I like the access of really being able to get as much concealer as I want personally when it starts getting low. I will tell you, this is the most difficult stopper I have ever popped out of any product ever, and I have popped a lot of them. And it makes sense because it is such a large tube, but my god, that thing was just like way down in there. It was hard plastic. It was a son of a bitch to get out. And I nearly gave up, but I had like mangled it so much. I'm like, oh, I don't want to leave it in here now. So I persisted and I was able to get it out. So that is definitely progress, absolutely, but I'm still really nowhere to finishing it up. There is a lot of product, as usual with any concealer. Once you pop the stopper out, you can still get a lot of uses out of it. I have a pretty good feeling it'll be gone before I need to move. All right, next we have the Soap and Glory One Heck of a Blot Mattifying Powder, my holy grail setting powder. My God, this thing has taken so long to use up. I have used it so incredibly consistently since the day I bought it. Although I do typically use a velour poof, I've been using a brush lately just to kind of switch it up a little bit, but I typically apply powder with poof. And I think maybe that makes the powders last longer. I don't know. I bet it does, because you're not really getting that kickback, that fluff up. You're not really losing product when you dab at it with a poof. So I bet that's why this has lasted so long. Anyways, I love it. I'm not complaining. I'm just saying. So this is a product that is very near the end of its life. I'm willing to bet it's going to be gone this time next month. I did repress it. It was fine. Repressed very, very well. And as you can see, I've hit major pan in there again. There's really not much left in there at all. What is left in there is very thin, although it doesn't take a whole lot, and I'm not like super powdering my face into an oblivion anyways. But yeah, I'd say it might last me another month or so, but I bet it'll be gone by the update next month. So anyways, that is where I am with that one. All right, and let's move on to cheek products. I am trying to use up the highlighter from the Charlotte Tilbury Foam Star Bronze and Glow palette. Again, only the highlighter side. And I still have a really long way to go on this, and I'm hoping I can use it up in the next 3 months. I think it's going to be close, but possibly doable. I don't know. I mean, I've made good progress. I've cleared out this whole corner over here, but these have a lot of product in them. They do. So I don't know. Although at the end of the day, I wouldn't bring this with me anyway, so if there's a little bit left, I'm just going to declutter it. I'm not really that concerned about it, but I would like to feel like I've at least got some use out of this thing that I spent so much money on. All right, next I have a brow product. It is the Ardell Brow Sculpting Gel. It's basically just a clear brow gel. It's a good clear brow gel. I've gone through multiple tubes of it. I very, very much like it. And it lasts forever, especially for like a $3, $4 product. You really get your money's worth out of it. Although I do absolutely wish that they would not make the container clear, because it gets so gross after a while. So I've really been dedicating myself to using only this. I have the Essence Make Me Brow, which I very much enjoy using, but have not been touching at all, to focus on this one. And I can definitely see progress. I can see gaps and everything in there, but my God, I feel like I'm not really getting anywhere with it. Again, this is another one where I'm gonna see how far I can get. Hopefully I can use it up. It may dry out before I get to the point of actually using it up, because it has been open for a while and I have no intention of taking it with me. So however far I get is how far I get. If it's still hanging around by the time I have to pack and move, it's going in my empties. All right, and then I have a little eyeliner here. It is the Urban Decay 24/7 Eyeliner in Perversion. This did start out as a mini eyeliner and was not a full size. But that being said, I've actually made some good progress on it. I use it every single time I do my makeup. Although I pretty much only do eyeliner on the top waterline, so you know, it doesn't really take a lot. But these pencils, in my opinion, go really fast. I have to sharpen this nearly every single time, at least every other time I use it. So you can see there, I'm holding it at the base where the pencil starts. I only have, you know, what is that, 3-4 inches of it left. So I think I'll be able to finish it up in the next couple of months, which will be nice. All right, and this one I'm really excited about. After months of having like no progress, I have like got another wind or something like that, my second wind with the Modern Renaissance palette. I don't really know what it was, but for a while there, especially in the spring, I just felt really stagnant with it. I really had no interest in using it, except when I wanted to. Like if I wanted a specific color out of it, fine, but as far as like using it every single day, I really wasn't that interested in it. But I have gotten back into it and gotten into it hard too. I have made some good progress. So there are a lot of changes from the last time that you saw this. I have used up 2 shades completely, and I think I have one new pan. So hopefully you can see here that I did finally finish up Tempra. Of course, I didn't really have a whole lot of that one left at all. I did repress it, and then again, it was pretty quick to go after that. I didn't have a lot, but it just kept hanging around and hanging around because I would forget to use it all the time. Anyway, so that one is finally gone, as well as Primavera. It is completely gone as well. absolutely beautiful gold shadow. I would put it right up there with like Half Baked as like the best gold shadows of all time. I think it's absolutely beautiful. Also, Golden Ochre, I have made some really good progress on. As you can see, there's not a whole lot of it left either. I have hit pan on two sides and expanded the pan in there pretty well. That shadow like explodes every time you touch it with a brush, so you know, not too surprised about that. And then the new pan, I believe, is Cypress Umber. It's just little baby pan, but it is there, using it like lower lash line, darken outer V. I don't really know where I'm gonna go moving forward with this. Like I said, I've kind of been thinking about like maybe focusing on these last couple of warm tone shades down here. I've also been thinking about knocking out Vermeer. I love it. I would like to use it up. And then Antique Bronze as well. So I'm a little bit undecided. I'll figure it out. But right now I have the motivation to use it, and so I'm going to embrace that and keep going with it until, like I said, I have no more motivation to use it anymore. But I would like to see this really beat up and used and pan all in it and as many shades used up as possible before I move, because I'm pretty certain. I mean, there's just no way I'm not going to take it with me. And it's really past its prime to give it to someone. So I'm just going to use up what I possibly can. And then by that time, it's really just going to be like fit for the trash heap. So that was everything from last month's project pan. So like I said, used up two products, and then literally everything else I have really good progress on. So I'm pretty happy with my results. And I think this coming month, I will really see some things start to fall. So I have decided to add in a couple new products, of course, replace my perfume of the month, etc., etc. So let's go ahead and get into those. So I finished that Givenchy perfume quite a few weeks ago, not too long after my update. So since then, I have actually been working on a Juicy Couture scent called, Couture La La? I think it's Couture La La. Yes, it is. There's so many and the names are so similar. So you may have remembered in my last video, I said that I was going to work on my Sol de Janeiro Brazilian Crush Body Mist after I finished that one. And when I finished it, I was looking around at all the little perfumes, like the little perfume bottles I had, and all of the ones that were not cruelty-free, and it's like, I don't want to move these. I don't want to move them. I would rather move that big body mist than move like all these tiny little perfumes. I don't want to move with anything that's not cruelty free. That's a really good place to like make an entire fresh new start, right? And I realize my perfumes are the last thing. Like my nail polish, my skincare, my makeup, everything else is cruelty free. Hair care, toiletries, all that. So perfume is the last thing. And it's only because I've gotten so many gifts, you know, over the years that I haven't been able to like control the intake. Anyways, basically I decided to put the body mist, the Brazilian Crush body mist, on hold. I'll deal with it at a later date. Maybe next, I don't know. I'll figure that out when this one's gone. And I decided to go ahead and knock this one out. It's a light, springy, sweet summer scent, and so it's like perfect for this time of the year. I can't really overdo it. It's just like a great scent that I knew I could use up. And as you can see, I have just about done that. I did put a mark on it when I started. It was practically full. I have used it a few times, and that'll be gone probably within the next week or two, and then I'll move on to something else. I am gonna add an eye primer in. This is the Essence I Love Color Intensifying Eyeshadow Base, and it is a damn good eye primer, especially for how cheap it is. It's really good. I very, very much enjoy it. But I do have still an eye primer, the Urban Decay Original Primer Potion, and so really don't need to be traveling with both, even though I really like this one. I'm not positive if I can use this up or not. I mean, you may can see like I have some gaps in there, but I still have a significant amount of product left. So I don't know, this one may be a long shot, I'm not quite sure, but I definitely don't need two eye primers on hand at the same time, and I do enjoy this one, but I could just as easily use it up. So we will see where I get with this. All right, last products and then we're done. I am adding in my two summer foundations, and I nearly did this last month, but then for some reason I decided against it. But this is all I've been using essentially since I've returned from Maui, so you know, why not just go ahead and get as much use out of them as possible. So basically I have the e.l.f. Acne Fighting in the shade Beige, and then the Wet n Wild Photo Focus in the shade Peach Natural. This one matches me better than this one, in all honesty. And this one is what I've used more of as well. In fact, I don't really have a whole lot left, about a quarter of the bottle, and it's not perfect. I may actually even have less than that of what I can actually get out of it, so we will see. So I do have some confidence that I will actually be able to use this up, and actually the lighter shade, I have my winter shade in this, is Rose Ivory. I bet I can actually use both of them up before I move, but we will see. And then of course the e.l.f. Acne Fighting, this is really hard to mark because of the packaging, but it looks like I'm about right there. So we will see. We will see. I'm honestly really conflicted about what I'm gonna do for foundations. These are the only two like summer deeper shades that I have right now, but they've been open a little while. I would like to use them up. And then I know damn well my lightest winter foundations are not gonna work for me at all when I move there. So I don't really know what I'm gonna do. I would really like to pick up the new ColourPop No Filter foundation. They look like they have great shades, like so many cool toned options that will actually match me, like even into the medium range, like for the deepest of the deep in summer, deepest of the deep for me in summer, like about this shade. So yeah, maybe I'm kind of planning on maybe picking up a couple of bottles of that, a deeper concealer from ColourPop too, crossing my fingers, hoping I like it, and moving with those. So we will see what I actually end up doing. All right, y'all, well that is my update for my makeup basket over the last month. Let me know what you've been up to, if you've been doing any panning, makeup basketing, etc., etc. I would love to know. And I will see y'all in a couple of days in my next video. Love y'all. Bye.